Greetings, fellow Ooplings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall. Today's task at hand is to actually go ahead and find Lord Woodborne so that we can exact King Lysandus' revenge on him. Now, I have got no idea where he could be. It says Lysandus' ghost appeared to me and told me that only the death or humiliation of his murderer, Lord Woodborne, would lay his soul to rest. Lord Woodborne is a noble of Wayrest and betrothed to Princess Elysana. He has a castle in the wilderness of Wayrest. Now, I wonder... Yeah, that's all it has to say. I've tried asking NPCs about it, but, well, nobody seems to really know where Lord Woodborne's castle is. So, I figured we will try and first find out where it is through the map by simply typing Woodborne. That might help. Oh, right next to the lake, I see. Woodborne Hall. Okay, I see. Traveling by ship saves us 2 days. Might as well, right? I'm guessing it saves us 2 days. 2 days. 2 days, because we didn't have to get across the damn lake that was in front of this person's home. There seems to be a moat here. Anyhow, I can see somebody over there. I don't know who that is, but I see something over there, and that's another horse. I'm guessing that's another horse. So, anyhow. Yeah, let's go ahead and get Lysandus' revenge. Now, the deal does say death or humiliation, but since we are in fact lagging. Yeah, hopefully it won't lag again. I think for some reason, like, it lags once when we're playing Daggerfall, and then it just stops lagging all of a sudden. So we approach it from behind, and apparently this is where we had to go. Yeah, we will not. This looks like a grand palace, to be honest. I don't know where Lord Woodborne would be in here. So since we are a warrior, we will not be humiliating him in any way. I do recall reading the fact that there were some ways to do that back when I started playing, started reading the synopsis of the main quest, but in this instance we will not be resorting to any of that trickery. We will be slaying him, exacting Lysandus' revenge on his behalf. Well, I see somebody right off the bat. Okay, somebody hit me with something. Oh, it was an Orc Shaman, I see. Orc Shaman died as well. I wonder what this guy is doing allied with Orcs. You know what? This might just be evidence that Gortwog is involved in all of this. If there is an Orc Shaman here. Unless it's just, you know, the game's shenanigans, but I don't think it is, because look here, this guy's worshipping Daedroth. Left and right, and yeah, this guy's a Daedra worshipper, and on top of that, oh, there are two more doors there. What the hell is this? Is that like a? Oh, okay, that's like a platform of sorts. Okay, I see. I think we need to find mechanisms to activate all those stairs to go up. I'll save here. Although I just saved outside, I know, but I still did kill all of those folks. Might as well rest here until we fully heal them. I'm healed. Might as well update that save in that regard. Shall we try touching the statues then, seeing what happens? Nothing happened there. Nope. Nothing happened there. Now we do have potions of levitation. We can probably just levitate all the way up there, but I do sort of want to play this game properly, considering the fact that this is my first playthrough. How did you open the door when you weren't even aware of me? Makes no sense to me, actually. And the game even played the sounds of this guy moving, which was absolutely not the case. That guy was not moving. Another Orc Shaman. And he's going to disappear anyway. He did. How is he so How are these guys so powerful? How are they parrying my hits? Is it just like a bad case of timing, I wonder? Ooh, adamantine cuirass. Now, this would be amazing if I did not already have an orcish cuirass on me. I tried to pick it up just to sell it off, but apparently that is not allowed. Wait, is this like a hidden door or something? I thought I could have sworn it was. It sort of looked like that. Okay, let's move away from here because the audio is glitching out over there. Okay, I'm assuming there are no hidden doors there. In either side. So I'm guessing the way to... the mechanism to opening the steps up is through one of these here doors. Let's go ahead and save again. Saving frequently is how you play this game. Yep. Ah. This will most likely take us up. Roots, just roots. I wonder if this is like a sneaky way through or whether this actually opens up the mechanism for us. Oh wait, there's no elevator coming down? What's going on? Did that open the steps up or something? I don't think so. I think it just like brought an elevator down. Yeah, there's the elevator. Took your sweet time coming, didn't you? Alright, let's what the hell? Come back! No, come back! Who gave you the right to go back up like that? It just literally vanished into the air without even bothering to wait for me. Here's another. But, that's strange, this one goes down. Was that a bug or was that like just trollish design by intention? I can't even see up there. Waiting for the elevator to come down. It's either a very it is most likely a very long shaft because the elevators seem to have like the proper speed to it. It just didn't carry us up, is all. It's like the moment we stepped on it, it just rode off without us. Let's try going downstairs maybe? Unless this too suffers from the same bug. Of course we can't activate it from here. Ah, this one works fine. Unless we get stuck down there. Oh no, I missed a door. Okay, so this is where we were supposed to get off, I suppose. Unless you're not supposed to get off here. Some of... that's a... interesting... greeting. Interesting thing to be greeted with. There's a hidden door right in front of us here. Oh, yeah, you can see it right on the map, actually. That's a... something. And a wraith. Are the enemies buffed up for this level, then, I wonder? Because they seem to be more difficult to kill. They're taking more hits to die. What is this? Purification? Don't think I would need it, but... I mean, I already have potions of purification, so I doubt I will need it. That did not work. Where's the other one? Oh yeah, right here. Sometimes things just vanish in this game. Which is... I mean, I didn't think that it would be an issue in this game of all things. I thought that that was only limited to Daggerfall, but maybe it's just my graphics rendering device that is acting up. I feel like. Could be the case, actually. You never know. There are folks on either side of us. Come on. And somebody over here, I wonder? No, that guy just... like... placed a... how do I put it? An explosion spell of some sort. Heal true. I just hope that I'm not wasting my time doing this. Spell sword, huh? With a staff. Not with a sword, but with a staff. Spell sword indeed. I'm just going in here just to mark these off the map so that I don't get confused later. That's a wraith. Wraith has died. Body, of course, has no treasure. So I guess we'll need to... go back up then. Because there was most certainly nothing on that side. However, there's like a trapdoor here, from what I can see. I wonder how we discovered all that. Huh, interesting. Oh no, that's just the platform, the steer platform, right. And that's the main entrance, the room next to the main entrance. No, there are no hidden doors there. Back to the elevator. I'll ride it all the way to the top before I attempt to jump back down. Because from what I feel like, I might probably be stuck if I don't, if I fail to call the elevator back down. I don't think I see a switch there. So just to be safe, I'll ride it all the way up and then come back down. I mean, I do see a switch here. Oh well, too late. Thankfully, this elevator ride is a short one. I see somebody opened up the door to our right. And that's a majestic orc, or maybe an orc chief. Orc warlord, right. Something along those lines. I remembered it being something along those lines. Cannot carry any more stuff, maybe that's too much gold to loot. I mean, thus far the dungeon seems pretty straightforward, but let us not jinx it. You never know. You never know. That's a mummy and a skelly. The mummy got away with me first, but the skelly still... oh my god, did you see that skeleton? It wasn't aware of me until it swung at it. And then it did like a backwards block. That's another thing there? Maybe I should save here before I touch that. I have a feeling that it might just... trap me in here somehow. Somebody open this gate. Like, these guys literally spam all the spells they have in their inventory. Literally spamming spells, nothing else. That's all these guys do. Enemies nearby? Oh, I guess we'll rest at a later time. Then. I suppose we need to just go about and activate all the levers to bring down the steps. I suppose that is a legitimate way of doing it. I do not see any levers here though. Not one lever. So I suppose this room is a dead end. I mean, this was just a bonus area for us. Let me rest right next to this cage here. My stealth has improved. I don't know how, but I don't know how my stealth keeps improving given all the extra weight that I'm carrying. But my stealth seems to improve. Now then, this switch here. Alright. Yep, it does take us upstairs. So, no need to fear that. And we're back up here. Nice. Now to clear out the other side. Okay, the steps thus far have come down. I wonder why this... the platform still isn't down yet. I'm guessing it's meant to do that. Some of the platforms in this game are intentionally bugged. Although, I'm guessing calling them bugged might be the wrong thing, because they're not exactly bugged, they're just... It's intended for them to not work, is what it is. Oh, okay. How do I get up now? I suppose we need to go up the other side and just activate the rest of the stairs as well then. Oh well, here we go. Do I just have to climb this thing? I guess. Let's try. Come on, start climbing. You can do it. Come on. Good job. See, you can climb. And then fall to your death, of course. But you can climb. I feel like I'm climbing in the wrong direction here. Didn't take a lot of fall damage, to be honest. Oh, I fell into like a second floor. Okay, that's cool. Let's go ahead and search on this side then. I just want to do this quest as legitimately for a warrior as possible. I don't really want to use hacks or anything of that nature. So, to that end, not exactly. I'm trying to exploit the game as little as possible. Only when it is necessary is when I exploit the game. That's another switch. I'm pretty sure that is supposed to call the elevator down, but I think that is broken. Because that is how it was the previous time around. A broken switch that did not work at all. Thus far, this dungeon has not been that expansive. This guy's unawares of me. I feel somewhat bad, I see. That was a barbarian. Swing and a whiff. Now what do I have? I've been poisoned, alright. Let's take a potion of cure poison. Or might as well refuse that. I'm healthy. Cool. As simple as that. Sometimes I look at the walls and they look like hidden doors. But no, that's just the texture glitching out as well. No hidden doors here. Excuse me. I was checking for any hidden doors here, but that's why I said no hidden doors here. Sort of sounded like... Oh, okay, this one takes us down. Should be cool here then. I guess we might as well try. But let me save the emergency slot before I go down. I hope it does not kill us. This elevator seems to be working just properly. I hear a rat. I kill the rat. I am simple man. I hear rat, I kill rat. Said the Russian. And that's pretty much it. There's nothing else here really. No hidden doors, no levers, nothing. I wonder why this was even a place. Interesting. Maybe just to throw us off, I guess. And this elevator actually takes us up, back up as well, so... I don't know what happened with that, but I guess that was a dead end. No mechanisms for us to activate here on this side. Now, did I miss like a door over there? I think I did. I think it may just be a hidden door then. Yes, it was a hidden door. Alright, we're going to get to that hidden door. Let's try searching for it with our bare eyes. I can't find it. Can you? Where's the hidden door? like they're supposed to appear different, but a lot of times they just blend in with the environment a little too well. Okay, this one. That's nice. Yeah, at least we got one, right? That's more than we could have asked for, to be honest. Now, the question is, how do we get there? Because you can't exactly climb onto surfaces. I guess we're just gonna have to go ahead and use a potion of levitation then. Like, if I was going to use it, might as well use it. For a different occasion, but I guess this is where we're using it then. Let's take the first left. Let's see what this area has to offer. Enemies, that's what it has to offer. One of them is a battle mage. And the other is a melee class. Well, not a battle mage exactly, but a spell sword rather. Barbarian. The thing about barbarians is sometimes they poison their ebony beasts. These would have sold for a lot, actually. Can I carry them? No, I cannot, of course not. Wait, didn't I just... Yeah. I was wondering. I wonder why I'm still trying to loot the corpses. Even though I know that they will most likely have nothing of value to offer. And are there like any hidden doors? Oh wait, there's another door here. There's just some loot and nothing else. Cannot carry any more stuff, of course. Of course I cannot. Any hidden doors? No? None? Okay. Back up we go then. Let's just rest here until we're healed. And I'll save here. This dungeon has been fun thus far, I'm not gonna lie. I have been finding it quite fun. Albeit a little... how do I put it? Boring, to put it in a way. Okay, I hear some sort of thing walking around, but I do not see anything of that sort. Oh, there's a hidden door to my right. I completely missed that. Unless, oh wait, that was the other room that I had not checked. Of course not. Ha. Now, here's the thing, this wine and stuff here, which makes me wonder what's going on. Let me save in this slot here. Can I, like, touch these? No, these are just decorations. Let's just give me a moment there, would you? Alright, we're back. I do not think this place has any hidden doors. Does not seem to be the case. But I do see something here. Maybe it has the... It definitely has something behind it. An Orc Shaman is what it has behind it. But apart from that, does it have anything of material value? Sorry, immaterial value. Something that we have not... gained thus far. Access to some stairs, perhaps. Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Amazing. I knew my trip here would not be a waste, says the guy who was skeptical about coming here all the while. And, yeah, I do believe that's all there is to this side. That should have now successfully called on all the elevators. I guess this elevator is just dead. We fell a long way and we took a lot of damage, but guess what? We're just gonna rest it off until we're fully healed, of course. The good thing about handmade dungeons like these is that once you clear it of enemies, there are none. My jumping has improved. That's a horrible way to put it. My jumping has improved. Now it's a straight way to the top if you wanna rock and roll. There are also some platforms here. I wonder if that was just like a mistake, but I think I see something there. Right now I wish I had that scooping ability from Delta Force. Oh no! Oh, okay. That works, I guess. I was too eager to look at whatever there was on top of the pedestal and I fell off the side. I did not expect there to be a side, but there was apparently a side to this. Oh, there's loot over there. Okay. I mean, I can't exactly carry... Okay. Did I just pull up my... Yeah, let's just do this. Wait, let me grab my bow, then I'll show you who's the boss. Bye. I guess you didn't want to know who's the boss. Couldn't rest now. Let's equip these again. I'm glad that I got the chance to shoot some arrows. Spent a few points towards my archery skill. I'm just gonna let it happen naturally since we are not in the middle of a fight right now. I feel short from this perspective. Ah. You were not aware of me, you see, but I was aware of you all this while. Barbarian died. I wonder if their weapon is poisoned, like all the other barbarians. Well, it's not poisoned all the time, always. Sometimes it is, yes. But not all the time. Okay, let's see what this... how big of a mess this will be to. Given the size, I'm quite certain that this is a labyrinthine dungeon. Although we are yet to get to the labyrinthine part of it. And just when I said that, we find this module here, which is essentially the... the... in my opinion, the worst module ever. This endless maze of what I can only describe as catacombs. I wonder why my game is lagging. Maybe it's because I minimized out of it for a bit. I thought I saw a way to climb upstairs. Somebody opened like a couple of doors. And I don't know who it was. But yeah, we're gonna get to the... Did we just do like a full circle here? I think we did. Orc Warlord died. Poor guy. But yeah, if anything, I would say this is proof of Gortwog's involvement in the matter. What is that? I missed a hidden door. Should we go back for it? Let's just trudge onwards for now. And this cursed place actually has two of these accursed maze-like chambers. I hear orcs. Okay, no orcs here. I guess we'll first go back and clear out that hidden door over there. Whoa, this has surprised me. I did not expect to see him there. Ooh, it's a data plant, so too bad I can't carry any more stuff. I wonder why I'm still searching. Probably because I've still got mithril gauntlets and greaves. Is why. That guy gave me a jump scare. I hear some guys. Wait, this was not a hidden door. My bad. Or maybe it was. I think it was a hidden door. From the looks of it. Just had one warrior behind it and he's dead now. Given the fact that I don't use the bow as much, I don't really need like an adamantium bow. Like anything better, a better quality, a better grade bow as compared to the adamantium bow. But yeah. Oh, okay, it's that room with the trap in the middle. Just that, nothing else. Unless... Okay, so this is... Yeah, this is not gonna be a good room. We're not gonna go up there. Unless we wanna use another levitate spell. Excuse me, though. I hear more rocks. So let's go orc hunting. I see an orc warlord to my right. I don't know where you came from, but well, you came. So that was good enough for me. Thank you for coming to my party. I hope you enjoyed your deathly experience. What is that? Big tooth? Okay. A strange artifact to be carrying around, but okay. That's the first time I've seen that, actually. This looks amazing. Steel red pauldron. I wish my Daedric gear would actually have trims, but it's difficult to find one with trims, actually. Unless I can change the appearance. Can I? I cannot use these, of course. Nah, the appearance of these won't change. Typically, when you press click on clothing items, it will change the appearance, but not in this case, apparently. I don't know where I go, but all I know is that I backstab an orc warlord, which did not even count as a backstab. Ooh, an adamantine dai katana. Katana. I don't know why I keep reverting to the American way of saying it, even though I know better. I guess it's just a force of habit. I should not exactly say reverting to, because I don't exactly revert to saying it that way. I just say it that way, automatically. Wait, what is behind me? No people ahead of me. Come on then. Orc warlord. Whatever you are. Shaman. Did this... Ah yes, I've been fooled by that wall before as well. It sort of looks like one of those walls that can be interacted with, but no, that's just the way the game renders the wall, because you're looking at it from two sides, so the back, the texture on the back does not exactly fit the texture. Oh, this is amazing. This is an amazing find. Let's remove that and put this on. Okay, how much gold do I need to drop for this? I'll easily discard like 1,000 pieces of gold, or all my gold for that matter, just to put this. Amazing. And let's pick this back up. Can we? Can. Amazing. All right. Of course, we cannot carry more stuff, but this is an amazing find, a huge find, a Daedric left falls on. That was one of the few links that I had always been missing, and right now, it's just a gauntlet, and once we get those, we will be completely set. So let's save here, since I actually have not saved in a while, to be honest. I feel like there's a guy behind this. There is, in fact. There was, rather. I've got a date with health and everything. I've got like the entire set, to be honest. I have no idea where I'm going. I'm just going where the road takes me at this point. And I have no idea where it will lead. I'll just eventually... Holy shit, this guy hits hard. I'm guessing he did that signature triple spell spam that spellcaster threw in this game. Like, anytime you encounter an enemy that can cast spells in the DOS version, they'll immediately blitz you with the same spell thrice. And that's essentially what causes... what can make your entire health bar go dead in a matter of seconds without you ever having to do anything. Now, would you have something that I can do for me? I don't think so. I think we already checked it, didn't we? Yes, we did. Now you. I wonder why this is highlighted. Of course, we cannot pick that up. Nothing here. I wonder how that woman got all the way there. Do not use an arrow. You used an arrow on me, didn't you? You fucking bastard. You used an arrow on me. Barbarian at that. Ill-bred swine. Why did it start climbing there? I'm guessing because the bottom of this wall is set up that way, I suppose. the chamber is sort of roundish, so yeah, these guys use the same spell thrice in a row. And I sort of got stuck there, and I'm definitely be resting after this encounter. Because otherwise it's gonna be my funeral. Seems I can't rest. Looks like I'll have to backtrack a little to rest. Well, backtracking would be the wrong word first. At this point I'm just looking for better replacements for my gauntlets and boots. Because the cuirass I have is pretty good, to be honest. It's a really nice cuirass. I'm also healing like super quick. So probably because my healing is at 100, let me just go ahead and check. Healing. I think it's a minor skill of mine. Medical 39? Okay. It's still a 39. I wonder why I'm healing so quick then. Yeah, did we check in here? I do not think we actually checked in here, we just came in here and cleared it out. Do not see any hidden doors on the walls. So I'll just let it be. The human enemy. But these guys make sense in this castle. But orcs, those guys are out of place. And given the fact that the developers had every opportunity to not put any, you know, non-human enemies in this little castle, I think Gortwog might actually be more involved in King Lysandus' death than we previously thought. We're stuttering again? Why, I wonder? It's strange, I never thought that Daggerfall of all things would stutter on my PC, but I guess it's the fact that I'm recording using OBS that's sort of the issue. Excuse me. That's great. That thing just started screaming right when I came next to it. I wonder if all this even leads to anything, or it's just like a giant waste of time. Because that is how things in Daggerfall are. Most of it is a giant waste of time, and you just sort of bump into the correct path later on. Somebody open this door. It's a giant of all things? What's a giant doing in here? But that makes no low waste connection. That makes no lore based connection at all. I was wondering why the dungeons we had encountered thus far are so linear. Because, well, the actual labyrinth is here. In this little section. Part of the game. Okay. You're that Lord Grimfangs. You've been a thorn in my side for a long time now. A wiser Lord would have let sleeping kings lie. Especially when I have gone to such great lengths to kill them. Yes, Grimfangs, I killed King Lysandus, and now it will be a pleasure to slay you. Oh God! I just added that bit on my own. I am done in. It is up to Gothred now. May you rot in hell, Grimfangs. I most certainly shall. Lord.
King Lysandus is at last able to rest. The wraiths and ghosts of his loyal soldiers vanish as his soul passes to the underworld, leaving the city of Daggerfall to the living.
Sorry, I was speaking with the mic off all this while. I was saying that we came here to King Lysandus and we killed him. We came here to kill Woodborne and we killed him. and that's all I wanted from this place. I do not want anything more, is what I was saying. Now, this seems to be the way back, and yeah, let's take that way then. We take a left. I just wish that I had saved before I bumped into... Well, what's his name? Lord Woodborne there, because it's sort of, the audio was sort of choppy, and that apparently, for in-game cinematics in Daggerfall, you need to cycle the frames all the way down to like 10% or 5000 frames a second. So otherwise, it just makes the... I'm stuttering a lot, aren't I? yeah, it's not just the PC that's stuttering apparently. And yeah, so the frames, they tend to... What the fuck? Just hit me. Well, I do not want to find out. No, I want to get out of this hole. I don't know what hit me, but that was hard. My god. I'll just go here and I'll rest for a bit. Let me just see if I'm... Yeah, I seem to be healthy. Some food came out for some reason. And yeah, and it just sort of killed me. And yeah, what the... In case you guys could not make heads or tails of it. Rogue, huh? I wonder if you're just a thief or you have some purpose here. Oh yeah, let me pull up the dragon and put this in. 195 gold pieces. Came here to rob me and got robbed instead, huh? But yeah, I don't really know. Yeah, I would like to go back to the door, I suppose. Yes, on ship. It took 10 days to get back. This is strange because it took me like 12 days to come and get to here. Huh, strange indeed. Even though I was coming all the way before you did. So, apparently Gothred is involved. And given the presence of the Orcs there, I would suppose so is, what's his name? Gortwog. Gortwog is just Gortwog, nothing else. Yes, we are on this side. Let's just go ahead and sell off our stuff first. I would rather not subject this video to nudity in case it gets taken down. Or rather demonetized, if it gets taken down from YouTube just using nudity. Yeah, I mean, artistic nudity does not really count. So anyway, I was saying that, so as soon as we knew Gothred, since Lysandus' revenge had been completed, his soul was finally free and his armies of the undead disappeared, is essentially what it said. Now, what I was saying earlier about... I wonder how long we're gonna have to wait here. 9 and 3 hours, okay. Yeah, so when you're playing in DOSBox, you need to set the cycles very low to like... to run it... you need to set DOSBox to run at around 5 to 10% of the actual capacity. So if you're, with the Steam version, you would typically be running the game at 50,000 cycles. So instead of 50,000 cycles, you want the game to run at something closer to around, well, 5,000 cycles. 5,000 or 2,500 cycles, and then in that instance is when the game runs properly. However, in my case, I could not really get a chance to actually set the cycles low, being the reason why that cutscene was so choppy. But yeah, that was that for Lysandus' revenge. We have successfully taken revenge on behalf of King Lysandus, for King Lysandus, and we have slain Gortwog. So that is what we came here for, and that is what we found. I should start by speaking to, yep, that curse has been wiped from our log, and that is it. Hey, I see you guys are admiring me. A cheerful young woman hands you a letter and then walks away, whistling. I wonder what that could be. Are you the cheerful young woman? No, you're standing here, you didn't walk away. Let's read that letter. Use, I guess? Grimfangs, come at once to Merwood and Wayrest. I will be waiting at the Fox and the Fairy for you. The fate of the Empire could be at stake, Lady Brisiana. Now this, will actually, once I go and meet Lady Brisiana, my character doesn't know it yet, but I guess I shouldn't spoil the game either, but yeah, this is the next quest in the main questline. So, Fox and the Fairy, we'll go meet her there. She says immediately that there's really no time limit for this quest. And as for today's video, this was that we adventured to kill Gortwog. We ventured out to kill Gortwog and we killed him. We slew him, we took revenge on behalf of King Lysandus. And that was honestly all we wanted to do. Typically, Daggerfall should be over by now. The two missions that Emperor Uriel Septon VII had sent us to the Iliac Raid to accomplish have been officially completed by this point in time. The ghost of King Lysandus has been soothed and exorcised by his own will, and we've also figured out what happened to the letter and returned it to the correct hands. However, there are a certain few missing pieces of the equation, such as the totem, this mysterious totem that everybody keeps talking about, the totem of Tiber Septon, and also like the heart, something of about the heart of some Numidian, which is apparently a giant golem of sorts, and how Emperor Talos, or what's his name, Tiber Septon, more or less betrayed his own battle mage during one of his battles to take control of the totem. And yeah, there are a few missing links here. I suppose it would be good if we began figuring out how these fare into the equation, but I suppose we shall learn more about it when we go ahead and talk to Elysana, because she says that the fate of the entire empire could be at stake. So at this point, I'll just leave it here, and thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we get back, we will be chasing the final promotion to Fighter's Guild before, of course, going to meet Brisiana, because, well, that's one of the things I just want to do. That's one of the things that Grimfangs wants to do. I'm pretty sure that nothing else is more important than what Grimfangs wants to do. So, until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Orcs.